Last time on Moreira.
Please don't forget to play my game, it's important. It's called Moreira. It's only a demo now, but please play it. It's great, it's about three cute girls. And you can date them, there's a rival named Gary. Who stands no chance as he tries his best. You know, totally not based on real life stories. Just please play it, I swear it's not crappy.
So here we are playing Gary's crappy ass demo game.
Let's see how crappy it is. I don't think I'm supposed to be here. This fault is nothing new to me. In fact, it's what I wake up to every single morning. I must admit it's a rather disappointing thought, almost as much as waking up hungry. Yes, hungry, as it tries to devour me day by day, to no avail. I never retaliate, yet it always stops after my first bite. I probably taste awful, like a sour grape. I've been here, I've been there, I've been in between. I don't believe in aliens, yet I always feel like one. Where am I supposed to be then? If only I knew. If only they knew. No one does, seriously. It's just some people are ridiculously good at hiding the obvious. After some time, I decided to change my strategy and get rid of every single thought appearing in my feverish mind. Completely, entirely, eternally. After some time, I found the best solution to do so. Something which I called mindless living as opposed to this mindfulness nonsense. Oh, so popular among the masses. Mindless living is easy. You simply need to be dead tired all the time. I mean, when you're exhausted, you don't want to think. You want to sleep. In a way, I decided to go through an inverted Maslow pyramid. Strangely enough, so my body got used to being deprived of sleep. I drastically cut down my calorie intake as the next step. This also allowed me to become quite slim. It concentrated me 100% on food and food only, regardless of how tired I was. Meat, fish, pasta, pizza. I could smell each of these words. But I'm not a monk or anything, so limiting myself that much became problematic. My stupid body craved sleep and food. Feed me! Get me some rest! Every time I succumbed to that voice of reason, I ate until I was about to blow up, and when I could sleep for a day or so, only to wake up and think, I'm not supposed to be here. I realized I struggled that much because I probably lacked training. After all, I thought, my mindless living should be treated not only as a clever invention, but also as a skill to develop. I decided to pursue a career in it, and shortly after I found my dream job. It was the number one on my shortlist. In fact, it got me enlisted. Yes, I joined the army. However, they fed me so well at the training camp that my silly mind decided to think again. So annoying, I'm telling you. And there was no stopping it. A phone started to ring in my head from time to time, driving me crazy. I know that as soon as I pick it up, I hear the same phrase. Hey, I don't think you're supposed to be here. That's why, as soon as I could, I asked to be moved away from a grass-fed heaven of a military base to a wild, stinky battlefield. Codename Hermes, that was my new name. Have you ever heard of a soldier named Ermi? Well, me neither. I've been the happiest man on planet Earth since my first deployment. But then it ended with a bus and a man who was not able to speak properly. At least that's what I last heard. The buzz of a bullet. Before it got so dark and lonely around me. Darkness gave way to a wide tube of light that sucked me in like a vacuum. What a strange place that was. Going all the way up to somewhere above the clouds. I could have sworn I saw familiar faces. Faces of people long gone from this world. They looked like they wanted to tell me something. But all I could hear was that annoying buzz. But maybe it, or maybe it sounded more like a distorted phone call. Doesn't matter though. I don't think I'm supposed to be here. I spent enough time in this otherwise unremarkable room, spared for a very weird note on a whiteboard. To leave this room, you must tell me the answer. What does it mean? Who? Me? What's the question to begin with? The only semblance of a hint came from a few more words below. 4 in total. Love, hate, life, death. Well, so what of it? Oh, this makes no sense. I know, dear. What is the question, I wonder? That's what my friend and I are trying to realize. Also, oh boy, I do not like this nurse. I feel like she's going to inject me drugs any second now and she's going to kill me. A young woman appears seemingly out of nowhere, dressed in an overly tight nurse uniform. She carries a syringe filled with a strange bright liquid. Who are you? And why are you in this room? Can you go away? All legitimate questions. My name is Sophie. Nice to meet you. As for my friend, he doesn't talk much, so I'm afraid I can't introduce him to you properly. Your friend? This better not be an imaginary friend of your imagination because you're crazy or something. Yes, here in my right hand. Oh boy, yep, I do not like where this is going. My precious friend who always knows the truth. Always, but today it seems. I thought back to my military training. The best way to deal with mentally unstable people like this girl is to take them seriously. Okay, fair enough. I guess it's nice to have such a wise friend. More like persistent, I should say. It takes my friend quite some time to kick in, but then there's no stopping him. And you're guaranteed to tell me everything I want. This is a truth serum, isn't it? She moves closer, and I can't help but notice that the button on Sophie's blouse is about to be ripped off by her boobs. Hey, darling, care to have a taste? Not at all! Who knows, maybe you're just pretending, not really to tell me the answer. I really want to get out of this place. I don't think I'm supposed to be here. Hey, me neither, girl. But please don't inject that truth serum into me. Stay away, she's clearly out of her mind. Thank you. I only like you. This room gets more crowded. Now that the second girl, rolled up in a latex costume, serving presumably no other purpose rather than an aesthetic one, shows up in front of me. Weird clubbing taste, but okay. I still appreciate you for saving me from that nurse. I'm much saner than you, Megan, right? At least I'm not making up a ridiculous explanation of what bound us all together here like you do. It's not ridiculous, it's true. I come from an era far more advanced than yours. I know things you can't even imagine. See, that's what I'm talking about. Megan thinks she's from the future. I mean, weird flex, but better to deal with than your crap. Still don't believe me? Fine. What's your last memory before you got here? I'm asking you as well, by the way. What's your name? Hermes. So, Hermes, do you remember anything? Oh, I heard your phone ringing somewhere very close to where I was. Not again. The second I say that, the phone starts ringing again. Ring, 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 ring. Like those machines and all detective phones. The sound becomes more and more loud. My head hurts. Someone should stop it. Pick up the phone, please. What did you say? Can you hear it? Hear what? That phone ringing over and over again. Jeez, it really gets on my nerves. My, this must be a hangout spot for weirdos. And I thought it couldn't be worse when our spaceship was invaded by those creatures. Please don't mess with it again, Megan. What are you talking about? Hang, is that? What a painful word. I was doing my daily routine. helping people to open up and talk. The guy we had back then, he just couldn't relax, he was so nervous. "You won't get a single word out of me," he shouted, rolling eyes like a madman. So silly of him. Then I heard the footsteps. Bam, we ran out of the door and barged in. "Hey girl, nothing personal, but we don't like to see our friends suffer. That's a nice robe you tied him with, by the way. Why don't we really put it to use?" Sophie shivers and stops talking. "I think I just realized that although we came from different eras, we share one thing in common."
"Yes, yes, we're all dead, yeah? Now we know what she's talking about, yeah?"
Okay, I love her. Yes, this is my new favorite girl. Damn it. A cute girl with a maid outfit joined the conversation. Where was she hiding? Weird. By the way, she has a plushie in one hand. Yep, my favorite character now. Nana is far gone into the back of my mind now.
"What, can't you see her, Nia? You can't you, Nia? You just don't want something, because I just misclicked."
This is where she keeps spouting nonsense.
"Well, I just tried to play this game, yeah? Unlike you, I realized these are all answers and death is the best one of them all, yeah?"
Oh, this phone again. "Death is certainly not an answer to anything, but, you know, if it tells us to get out of this place, I'm fine with it. We need to get back home."
"No one likes the dead coming back, I'm afraid."
"I'm not dead." I agree with Naomi. Maybe death is the ultimate answer to everything. At the very least, it has the ultimate degree of certainty.
"What?"
"Well, how do you know whether or not you actually live? What qualifies you as a living person?"
"Ridiculous, don't be silly. My heartbeat, for instance." "Then you compare yourself to an animal."
"You're getting on my nerves."
"Hey, I'm just trying to say that compared to the lives of some people, you're just occupying space. On the other hand, when you die, you're 100% dead. Everyone's equal 6 feet underground. No one can challenge this fact, unless you're only like 3 feet underground or you're like 10 feet underground.
Sophie, I don't think that matters."
"Yeah, shut up, you."
"Spoken like a true genius."
"I know, right? I'm an underappreciated asset."
"You probably are, because I don't appreciate you a lot right now."
"Where are you from again?"
"The present time."
Do you have the slightest idea how little that narrows it down?" "That is the answer simply because eternal life is much worse, yeah?"
"Say what?"
"I think I still have my magic powers to show you, yeah? Kitty cat, make me happy, make them sad."
I'm quite sure she's the faint with plushie. So what's going to happen now?"
"Eternity."
"What do you mean?"
"Time will go, but we won't follow."
And she was right. Oh shit. We are stuck in Zavarudo. The world! The kitty cat!
What day is it today?
Friday, yeah?
Jeez, how would you know? Thanks for your trick, telling us its meaning.
Therefore, it might as well also be Friday.
It's been, what, days, months, years?
Hey Naomi, can you revert your spell?
If you all admit death is the answer, maybe I could?
Okay, I admit it.
No way I'm going to follow this trick. You want to stay here forever? Fine, let's talk. Little by little, the future will come and that's exactly where I'm from.
Okay, let's talk about cats.
I'm on board with that. And so we did.
Let's talk about food.
I'm on board with that. And so we did.
Let's talk about fun.
I'm on board with it, and so we did.
Let's talk about films.
I'm on board with that, and so we did.
Let's talk about fiction.
I'm kind of on board with that, and so we did.
Let's talk about friends.
I'm absolutely on board with that, so we did.
Let's talk about freedom. That's a nice topic. I'm on board with that, and so we did. Let's talk about feelings. Yes, absolutely, I'm on board with this, and so we did. Let's talk about faults. I'm absolutely not on board with that, yet still we did. Let's talk about foxes. Absolutely on board with that, and so we did. Let's talk about forests. Eh, sure, why not? And so we did. Let's talk about fonts. Well, as a major designer, I'm absolutely on board with that, and so we did. Stop it! I can't take it anymore! Oh, I can still take plenty more of that. Fine, maybe death is the answer. Whatever. I too agreed with that. However, nothing happened. What's next? What should we do? I think we should be more proactive now that we all agree on our answer. Serious weapon liquid? It's the last resort liquid, so to speak. Let me help you, friend. Nope, stay away from me! She moves so swiftly, it doesn't even hurt. My vision starts to become blurry. God damn it! I hate you. We found things again, but this time I managed to answer it somehow. The guy on the other end of the line tells me that if I die, I stay in this room forever. Why haven't I thought about it before? I'm afraid it's too late now. Love. Love. What is love?
Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. No more.
Pardon me. Hi, what would your order be? Naomi, you're alive? Yes, you are the most important person to be alive. Let's marry.
Yes, why?
However, I woke up in this room today. You know, that milk tea I had yesterday? It tasted so weird. Anyway, although it's not my turn anymore, I certainly have a customer.
What can I order?
Nothing, I'm afraid. We've had everything. But I can make you company. I'm a good mate after all, yeah?
Did you see the strange whiteboard?
Sure I did. What do you think the answer is, yeah?
Love.
How romantic of you. Sadly, I know nothing of it. I'm not allowed to get into an affair with a customer, even if one as handsome as you.
Oh, thanks, kitty.
However, let my magic do the work and say whether or not you're right, yeah? Kitty cat, make me happy, make them sad.
I love this. Two other girls appear right in front of my eyes.
God damn it, the nurse is back.
Tell me, what is love?
Love is reducible to the absolute act of chemicals. Therefore, there's no intrinsic value in this material universe. Hypocrite that you are, for you trust the chemicals in your brain to tell you they are chemicals. All knowledge is ultimately based on that which we cannot prove. Will you fight, or will you perish like a dog?
Sorry, they're a bit broken. Let me fix it, yeah?
Oh my god, she's a demonica, isn't she?
Tell me, what is love, yeah?
Silence was her answer.
Oh my, still no good. Well, let me try this little trick. In a second, they're going to fall for you, Hermes.
Can you please stop being being Monica? She specs me with her plushie. I notice Sophie and Megan staring at me.
Hermes?
Yes?
I love you.
If those were your true feelings, I would absolutely accept them, but I doubt these are your real feelings, so I have no choice but to reject you. So yeah, why?
Should I have a reason?
It would certainly help. No, but I'm curious.
Just because they're here.
And that's why you fell in love with me just now, okay. I've been here before.
People change, don't they? He's mine, he will be my darling. Only you and I forevermore.
Go away. Push, out of the room. I don't like you.
Hey, we're kind of stuck here together.
But if you could leave, which one of them would you choose to go out with now?
Oh, we have... This is an interesting choice. Nana, Marta, and Sima. So, anyway, since we are going back to these three names that we haven't heard in forever. I would say go with Nana.
You're being weird. I don't recognize any of these names.
Well, I do.
It tells me that you'd think of Avagus during a moment like this. Yeah, how could you? You're so shut up. From another side, love is the most selfish feeling anyway.
What?
Selfish, of course. Is that eternal? And what is eternal love? Eternal love means you should stay together until the very end. Till death do us part. Now, I'm sure that after some time, you're definitely going to choose me over anyone else.
Absolutely not.
The question is, how can I be sure that the feeling lasts forever? It never lasted in the first place.
What are you talking about? Stop babbling nonsense.
Trust me, my words make perfect sense. Here, let my friend explain this to you.
No, stay away, stay away!
Just a few quick swings, and shortly after that, you're the only one standing in the room.
Ah!
What have you done? How could you? Same as you, I'm just being selfish. All fair and square. Fair, you know what? Love is not the answer. Love is not fair.
I have a cold sweat dripping down my back. Sophie's clearly bonkers and I need to calm it down somehow. Not fair, but why? I always thought love is one of the best feelings in the world. I never said it's bad, I said it's not fair. Love should be mutual, but it never works that way. Remember, Hermes, between two people involved, one loves and the other allows himself or herself to be loved. How is that fair? I don't believe you. Oh, and love is also very selfish, remember? Even more selfish than you and me.
Well, you are certainly selfish enough.
What about love you have for your parents? It all goes down the same street. Every time you buy them something, you feel like a good kid. In a way, you buy it for yourself. Hermes, now, what I'm going to do is to have you all for myself.
How about no?
Swing the needle, bites me like a snake, my legs start to tremble, and I'm fucked.
It feels so satisfying. Sophie's face is the last thing to flash in my mind before darkness covers everything around me. God damn it, I hate drugs so much.
Ah, hi, I'm back from my dad, it seems.
Even more than usual course here, as if nothing happened at all. The phone starts ringing again.
I don't think I can get rid of the pain in my head, so I badly need to concentrate on something else. Maybe small talk can help.
Hey, do you guys remember what just happened? Nothing yet? We have to find the answer, and...
And I'm sure the answer is one of us worth, yeah?
You're kidding me. Have they entirely forgotten about what happened before? Which word could it be?
Easy! Hate! Hate's the answer, yeah?
Why do you think so?
Well, I hate you all, so this was definitely a suitable answer for me.
That is absolutely not right.
For you, yes. For me, no. But why would I care about you, Nia? I wonder what's the reason for hating us that much.
Yes, I want to know too.
It's simple, you know, Nia. I hate you because you leave me no hope, Nia. I hate despair. I only love Naruto Komeda, who's all for hope. Oh, yeah.
Why, I wonder?
If you're right and I came from the past, then I see my future in the two of you. What can I say? This future looks pathetic.
But you don't know us at all.
Even 5 minutes is enough. I despise you.
Her annoyance doesn't seem to be justified at the very slightest, not at all. But I'm not surprised, as it fits perfectly with the weird ambience of that place.
I don't think hate is the answer because it's too easy to hate something.
And who said the answer should be complicated?
What do you hate, Hermes?
You? I hate you a lot. Other people? Especially you, Sophie.
Including me?
Especially you? We just met, but I'm sure I'm capable of developing a whole nano-angstrom of hate directed towards you specifically.
Why?
Because you're a creepy-ass nurse bitch who has already dropped me at least 2 times, 3 times, maybe 4 times, and I'm pretty sure you're going to drop me again.
Yeah, why?
Because you make me feel like I'm not supposed to be here.
What would have changed had we not existed at all? Then you couldn't compare. If he had no other place to be, his fault would become valid, yeah? I agree with you, Hermes. If I hadn't seen the future right before my eyes, I'd have been fine with everything, yeah?
You guys don't even know about the right reason to hate everyone around you. I mean, they exist, they smell, they take space, they're loud and annoying.
That's why I always stay in my lab, so I could have some personal space. But even there, when I visit the bathroom, I look in the mirror and realize I'm no different.
What about you, Megan?
I don't know. In the future, our personalities are removed as they serve little to no purpose. It doesn't sound like a nice future.
We don't live, we function. I still have some emotions, but hate is too strong off limits.
Wouldn't want to live there. Oh boy, hate, lots of hate, ugh.
Hermes, hi there! Finally, it's only me and you here!
But... why? Where are the other two? Where's everyone else gone?
What makes you think they've ever been here to begin with?
This is wrong.
Anyway, I'm here to support you, yeah? Trust me, hate is not the answer. Life, yes, life is! I wanted to know that you're supposed to be here with me. Stay with me forever, Hermes. Forever!
I mean, I like you and all, but I don't want to get Monica here. So, why are you so sure about it?
Because I don't think this place was supposed to exist in the first place. It feels made up. Therefore, you fit in perfectly. Think of it as a new life for both of us.
Life? You think life is the answer?
Yes, because I want to spend my life with you, yeah?
I would normally totally love it, but... what are we going to do?
Everything but one thing. We'll never work alone, yeah? And, you know, I'm a mate. I can always serve you a cup of tea when you need it. Trust me, having a friend like this is what matters the most.
Thanks, Naomi. I don't even know what to say.
It's because you actually want to spend your whole life with me instead, you know?
Nope, lies. Also, where did it come from? Go away. Where did Naomi go?
It doesn't matter.
It absolutely does.
It's just you and I here now, Hermes. You and I.
Help! No, please, somebody save me! What are we going to do?
We're going to have some fun, you know? Admit it, what do you really want?
No.
Everything else is just a facade to mask your desire.
I have absolutely no desire to even be within, like, 10 kilometers of you. That's not true.
Well, do you want my friend to ask you this question again?
Nope.
He didn't always answer out of you.
Absolutely not. Stay away from me. There's absolutely no need for that.
See? Now you're being frank. Don't worry, it's okay. Think of yourself as a part of the hunter-gatherer world. It'll make your life a whole lot easier. It's just you, the things you own, and the things you want to own.
But I don't want to think of you as a thing.
Well, then someone else would, my dear, and you'd be surprised about the choice I make.
Life is not as primitive as you portray it.
Life works the way you make it work, simple as that. I want my life to be primitive, so here I am. You know why you feel like you're not supposed to be here? Because you don't even know what kind of life you want to live. Don't worry, Hermes, let me take care of it. Let me comfort you, my dear, so you could forget about everything else.
Nope, stay away.
No way! Oh, thank you.
What just happened? Where is the Figo? Not that I care or mind, but just asking.
I got rid of a succubus. Thank you very much. Hey, stay with me, Hermes. I've seen the future and it's not the best one, I admit.
Yeah, it doesn't sound too nice.
Now we'll have a second chance to make it great.
What are we going to do?
We're going to believe it tomorrow. If you think you're not supposed to be here, make tomorrow the place to be. Please, do it for me.
Will you love me?
I love you of tomorrow, I promise.
Two roots. Well, that was the demo, folks. I tried to push the button, but nothing happens. Maybe I should try tomorrow.
Next time on Movie Era.
Oh! Oof! Ow! Right in my face. Yeah, it was right in my face. Ah, it hurts! It really hurts!